Who the hell, the man? What happened, Gucci Gang, man? Hey, yeah, no, man, hang it up.
The music video I've chosen for my first analysis is Hypnotize. Big released a song in 1997 to promote the album Life After Death. The music video used the typical stereotypes and conventions of the genre by using fast cuts, high and low angle shots, with a contrast of quick cuts, and set at certain locations such as here when Big is playing cards. The video starts with the caption, Florida Keys, 5:07 p.m. with Big on Puff hanging out with some women when a bunch of helicopters disrupts their party and attempts to capture them. Once we see them, we already know the music video is going to be a prestige of a Bond film. The tense and active mood is amplified by the tracking shots and fast cuts. All of these edits and camera angles sets the mood for the rest of the song. 50 seconds into the video, it cuts to a tracking shot of the helicopters going towards the yacht. This builds tension and suspense is created. After the beat drops, we see the scene move on with the actual song playing. The transition between Big, Puff, and the short movie clips are frequent and are often used to change to the beat. As you can see at 2:50, there's a very dramatic change with the amount of clips that they're showing. The effects used by the transitions during the movie clips and the actual performance helps to maintain a fast and action mood of their song. The relationship between the lyrics and visuals relate to an extent, as it is as if Big is illustrating his lyrics to the video. For example, he pushes the Lexus, meaning he drives Lexus, while in the video he's been driving Lexus. This is just a literal meaning of the song's lyrics in visual form. I could also notice the relationship between the music and visuals. As the music video started, the intro was with everyone playing cards. This was done by multiple long shots. This way they were able to get everyone playing cards all in one shot. However, as soon as we went past the intro, the camera mainly focuses on the main artist, which was Big. Hip-hop videos in particular do this because they tend to have many extras, and the purpose of a music video is to advertise the main artist, and this will be done with multiple close-ups of the main artist. There are many different intertextuality references in the video, and famous people are also used to promote the video, such as Puff, who was just dancing in a video, and the James Bond themed music video. The video is highly narrative based because it really tries to send out a message about many different issues around the world. To make a successful music video, lip syncing has got to have minimal errors. Lip syncing is when the artist will rhyme the words of the song to a camera, which will then be synced later on in the post-production. They can also mime the playing of an instrument to a pre-recorded track. I have noticed this throughout the song as Big was performing the song to a camera. In conclusion, the music video works extremely well for what it is designed to do, to send that awareness of what is happening. And this music video refreshes your mind whilst also pleasing your ears because it's a very well planned and performed song. The video fits in well with the hip hop scene because, as we know, hip hop is made up from many different subgenres, and this is displayed through different clips of issues around the world. I have chosen Miley Cyrus' music video We Can't Stop to analyze due to its richness in music video convention. The perception of the music video is that she is a young girl who is living life as she wants. The We Can't Stop music video is very sexual. This is portrayed through the camera angles. Through the music video, there are many mid shots. In one of the establishing shots, it highlights the top half of her body. This angle is used to show off her body. Throughout the music video, she wears minimal amount of clothes. The use of the mid shots are used to show this. While Miley is dancing in the music video, the camera angle converts to a long shot, This highlights her body once again and her friend dancing in a seductive manner. This adds to the fact that she wants to be seen as a sexual character to her audience. The lyric, "Shake it like we're in a strip club," then highlights that she's trying to be seductive and sexual by her movements shown with her body language. Miley is displayed as a sexual character through the video. This is highlighted by her outfits. The clothes she wears is minimal and very revealing. For example, the see-through swimsuits and crop tops. This is common in pop music videos as the artist is trying to gain the audience's attention. The video also represents the pop genre by using a lot of dancing scenes and close-ups of the star. The idea of the music video is for it to match the song. With the use of editing, it puts everything together in the right place. In the We Can't Stop video, there are many quick cuts. The use of quick cuts draws attention to different scenes and situations as they move swiftly. She uses the visuals as a montage to get through as much as she can. I think the use of the quick cuts is to show small snippets of her being crazy. As in the video, she has quick cuts of her being seductive and funny. This then highlights the different sides of her. The music video consists of fast-paced editing. Doesn't this match the visuals of the music? As you can see in the music video, a lot of scenes match the words of the song. The quick edit also gives it that sense that time is going fast. They are having a good time, so it's going quick. Where, as if they were bored, the edits would have been slower. Miley uses intertextuality in her music videos. Beats by Dre speakers are used to play a song throughout the video. This shows that they are loud enough to be used at a party. By sharing the speakers, he will encourage people to buy them, and it highlights that you're a good product. The lip balm was also used as a source of intertextuality within the video. This could also be a form of a product placement. EOS is a company known for their good skincare products. Miley uses the products in the music video as well as just showing the packaging. This shows the audience that it is a good product and will encourage people to use it.